Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm the Mysterious JG. Between videos, I was trying to find out information about the Epsilon program cars, and I accidentally stumbled across something I did not know, which is Marnie, the, rather pleasant, seems nice, but kind of deluded woman, that blonde woman in the Epsilon program who's been trying to, like, tell us that she's the queen of the sky and we're ex kicked out of our kingdom or whatever. Yeah, I guess she was a stranger and freak, stranger slash freak in GTA 4. Like, I didn't recognize her. But there was a character that Nico encounters, like, twice, who's just kind of in a bad way, getting involved with, like, addicted to drugs, and she's been turned out as a prostitute, and Nico kind of counsels her and tells her to move back to the Midwest and be with her parents. And that was one of the more uplifting stories in GTA 4, that she takes his advice and gets out of town. But apparently she decided to go all the way to the West Coast and is now a Scientologist. So anyway, so in my efforts to get information on where to find these cars, I found a YouTube video that opens with, "Hey there, gentlemen and ladies." Like, there's no indication at all that it's a joke. It's like some guy is just, like, creepily coming on to any women who may be watching his. This is O Lord O. Maybe if I watched more of O Lord O's content, I would get the joke. But he did appear to be just creeping on ladies in his video, and just like, "Hey ladies, any ladies out there wanna sex me up now that I've revealed information on the Kiflom cars?" But anyway, it is a simply, like, the first, like, I'm 18 seconds into this video and it is just showing me a map of where the cars are, and that is exactly what I want. So hopefully I'll get more instruction on how to, I'm sure the email said something. But the game may come in with a little message in the top left-hand corner that tells me where to take the cars, or I might just get a little, like, drop the car off at the selected point prompt. Something to know. How do I actually turn these cars over to the Epsilon folks? I also read up on the end of the Epsilon mission chain, and this is one where there's, like, a branching choice to be made. But I think thanks to the Strangers and Freaks mission replay feature, I can probably just do one and then replay and show you the other, which is a nice little thing. You don't have to use save states to see all the different outcomes. The Epsilon missions in particular, like, there's such a thing as, oh, I'll do a different heist option when I replay the entire game. It gives it replay value. That's cool. But the Epsilon missions are almost by definition, we haven't gotten to the worst of them yet, but they're kind of by definition meant to be this. What kind of sucker are you? Like, all this effort you're putting in to doing stuff for these guys. And that's only going to get a little bit worse. I think there's only two missions left after this before the final mission, but they are designed to be really annoying. Is this it here? Is this one of the vehicles? Because it does seem pretty unusual. This vehicle is wanted by the Epsilon program. Delivered to the location marked Epsilon logo. Okay. It's not too far away. I'm going to come off of this because I just don't know the, I don't know that station at all, and it might have very different copyright strike capabilities. This station, like, it's music I recognize from my childhood or youth, and it is, so far we've been really good with not getting copyright struck. I guess they're just like, these are straight up American radio faves. So YouTube is probably, I don't know. I don't know how copyright law works. I put a lot of effort, and not a lot of effort, I put like an afternoon, more than that. I was trying to come up with like a new sort of video I was going to do for the channel, and it would be, because I'd seen some video essays on stuff that seemed fun. I was going to do this really not serious at all, like, almost like watch along, like clips of this old TV show and me interrupting to monologue and joke about what was going on. And it was copyright strike bonanza. And then I kind of realized I'd seen videos like this, but they had probably had to go through a process of, because you can, if you get copyright struck, I didn't really find this out because I'd never really seriously pursued it. This is one where, oh, yeah, fair use would be the thing, but I guess there's a process to go through where it was like, yeah, there's no strike against your channel, but no one can see this video. And then I realized I could go through a whole fair use process, but do I want to? Do I want to put the effort into making a video essay and not knowing whether or not how long it would take to get a fair use exception, and whether or not I could be sure of it happening. 46 places at once, it's still stuck on the Olympic freeway. Kiflin, that's right. What? Buddy, you need to calm down. I guess he fled from that vehicle that got knocked over by a cop car. I understand that, but... But whatever. Wait, I'm stealing your car. Relax. Now, how I get it out of here? Now, we're full on Los Santos Rock Radio now. Yeah, this car, there is no escape for this car. This gate is not one that can actually be opened. These cars were built on the other side of this fence and can never escape.
I need to borrow your car, lady.
Kiflom. Alright, well, thanks to the magic of Olordo, who, you know, ladies, if you're listening, maybe consider, you know, Olordo has done me a solid here putting this video together and just getting straight to it with showing a map right off the jump and not talking and trying to get his, like, engagement up. He's got 20,000 subscribers. He's got 221,000 views on this video from 10 years ago. But, you know, he's put together a pretty good, serviceable, like, no-nonsense video for this. So, ladies, if you're listening and you know who Olordo is, go make sure to have dirty sex with them, okay? But anyway, thanks to Olordo, this won't be nearly as painful as it might have been. Although, honestly, this is like... I guess if all five cars actually have a point where they will appear on the map parked. Olordo doesn't deserve that much credit. There's a whole world of people who are putting together, like, webs... Like, even a text and picture-based website rather than a YouTube video showing you where all this stuff is at. Yeah, what made this impossible in the old days was that you would have to steal cars that there isn't a... Oh, that's the one I want, isn't it? Hold on. Well, I don't know that. Maybe it's one of these. Oh, yeah, it actually is one of these. So I thought, like, oh, this one's the challenging one. Because you got to go, no, this is actually... And it's always the same Kiflom garage. Kiflom very specifically wants his cars delivered to this garage. I don't have to worry about... I have to deliver them in good condition. I don't have to deliver them in, like, perfect condition. The thing is, this is not one of those where, all right, there's a certain amount of damage at which you fail the mission. But any damage before that decreases your reward. Like, no, this is just going to be like, you'll probably get a message saying the car is too damaged. Get it repaired. If you wreck it too bad. But we're not going to get a reward for completing this mission. We're going to get the next Epsilon mission, because the whole point is that we're an idiot being ripped off. Well, I guess AEW Collision is about to start. I haven't seen that one since the first episode, but after CM Punk left. When they didn't really acknowledge that, and I was kind of curious if they would. Because that had been, quote, his show. There was a little time. I still have my DVR set up to automatically tape them. When CM Punk was like the de facto ruler of Collision, I was watching it. It was a pretty fun show for a little while.
Kiflon, baby.
Kiflon, baby. I went into my thoughts on the whole CM Punk versus AEW saga in my actual AEW Let's Play. So if you want to hear more about it, you can go there. But yeah, there was a couple of weeks where AEW Collision, the B show on the B wrestling promotion, was pretty fun, old school in the sense of like how the storylines would be set up, and it was really enjoyable for a while, and then it I have not watched much of it since, but apparently it's kind of unwatchable now, so. All right, let's see here. Right here, there should be one. I've kind of gotten the ones that were really close without knowing where the drop-off point was. It is not shown on this map. That wasn't an actual song, or I guess it was that super annoying voice was the DJ talking over a song, I guess. We're keeping it going. Yeah, stupid guy with a stupid Euro accent. Can't stand Euro accents. Let's listen to some Elton John instead. See, I would have been able to recover that if I was Franklin. Freaking jerk wanted to turn left when I needed to be slamming through the intersection, ignoring all traffic laws. Alright, so somewhere in here, one of them is a motorbike, this might be it. And this is for like, how the hell is I supposed to recognize one motorbike from another in this game? It's not even one of the weird snake-themed motorcycles from Lost and Damned. Lost and Damned, by the way, that's gotta go down. I mean, let me know in the comments, folks. Is Grand Theft Auto, The Lost and the Damned, is that one of the coolest video game, whether DLC or just video game names ever, Lost and Damned? Auto Gay Tony, not a bad name. But, I know it wouldn't make any lore sense, but there should be some way to just all radio stations switch over to Los Santos Rock FM or whatever WKRP when Mike gets in the car. Kiflom better be impressed by how quickly we're getting all these cars. Although Kiflom, in his infinite knowledge, knows that it's really Olordo, the horny YouTuber who got us here.
Well done, Zolag. Well done. This is the work of a true thesis.
So he's making fun of it, but it's obvious he's absorbed some of the terminology, right? A good neighborhood to be in if you're just stealing cool cars. All right, we're most of the way there now. Oh, then I completely lost track of where we were. Okay. So we had stolen a car here, and the next one to steal is here, I think. It's a slightly different version of the map. Like, I'm not sure why his map, he's got streets in black and background in gray. I don't know if it's a different version of the game. But it's kind of right. It's around here somewhere. Small Faces, Ogden's Nut Gone Flake. I don't recognize the name, but I recognize the tune.
We're going on a drive now. Don't speak. Don't sing. I want to hear this Small Faces track and remember.
Don't speak. Oh, sorry, I spoke. I am somebody, I'm not considered fun on a car trip, because if other people start singing along with the song they like, I am the one who's like, no, shut up, I want to hear the song. Am I not, hold on, it said, I guess I hadn't moved my mouse in a while. My, laptop went to the screensaver. I briefly thought I wasn't connected to a battery. Alright guys, don't be gangsters. I'm sorry, it sounds like racist, but in this game, a bunch of guys start speaking Spanish, there's a decent chance they're gangsters. Well, I guess I'm just thinking back to when the Vaqueros, or whatever they're called, the Yellow Gang, just like freaking started murdering us at various points as Franklin. Hasn't happened to Michael. I feel like they just get hostile to anybody who's in their territory, but it would make sense that Michael they might ignore. He's just some like middle-aged white dude. Trevor looks like a fucking maniac, and I'm sorry, Franklin looks like a gangbanger from another gang. Captain Lyons. Only it's not really a ship, it's a yacht. And I'm not a captain. We're comrades. Memories are safe. Alright, this is just one of those songs. I'm like, why don't I remember the song better? Oh, it's instrumental. Unless lyrics are about to start.
Let's go to a place with no spell check, no social media, and no selfies. A place that's magic. Rock music has the power to change a lot of things. We won the Cold War with a guitar solo.
Did we?
But the 80s were kind of fuzzy. So were the 90s for that matter. But let's all medicate now with some music, shall we?
Oh, wow. I think I've told the story before about my middle... I don't know if it's 6th grade, 7th grade... Yeah. My middle school math teacher who was asked... It's like a getting to know your teachers kind of exercise. What's your favorite song? And this guy is teaching... He's teaching math to middle schoolers. He had this really big, like, over-the-top wax mustache. Like, he was somebody... He seemed to be, like, self-consciously a character. Because he had a kid. I remember his...
Don't be an antithesis.
He had, I know he was married with kids because like one of his kids was in the class, but he said his favorite song in the world was Highway to the Danger Zone. Now, I was a kid, I would have been going to school. I would have been in like middle school in like the early 90s. So it's not like it was a brand new song at that time, but this guy's favorite song of all the songs that human ingenuity has ever created, the most beautiful piece of music, according to this guy, that man had ever devised, was Highway to the Danger Zone. Kenny Loggins. Is it Kenny Loggins' best work? I'll let you decide. This portion of the song is, I think, undervalued. People tend to remember the chorus. But the bridge here, Highway to the Danger Zone, also an integral part of the greatest song that humanity has ever created. I mean, if it was just the chorus without the bridge, Highway to the Danger Zone might be only the third or fourth greatest song ever created by humanity. I know, I don't really have a lot of, like, concrete memories of being in middle school and elementary school. I think that's normal. Maybe I drank too much in college. I think it's normal that, like, there's individual flashes of things that stick with you and not that many. As you get to my age of middle school, but, I mean, you're going to remember your some of your first romantic type encounters. You're going to remember things that were really socially impactful to you in your middle school years. But, like, for me, it's like, I will never forget a teacher telling us, in all seriousness, when being asked what his favorite song ever was, that it's Highway to the Danger Zone. Oh, apparently this isn't the right one, because A, I didn't get a message. B, none of those other ones involved you having to break into the vehicle. And C, well, that's it. The fact that these guys are chasing us and are hostile is not mean that it wasn't one of the cars, even though none of them before had had anyone, like, defending them. But there you go. That pattern is reestablished now. If it's one of these Epsilon cars, it's never guarded. Let me see how much time I got left in this video. We're doing fine. I think we're going to get all this done in one video. And there's another red marker on this map that I'm looking at, but I'm not sure what it represents. Maybe there's like six places these cars can be, and I don't know if that represents something else. I haven't listened to the entirety of this video. I kind of stopped when I noticed that the map was there and gave me the information I needed and the guy was creeping on the ladies. But, you know what? I'm enjoying this song. And I've talked enough about Highway to the... Highway to the Danger Zone is the greatest song in human history, which is why I'm not going to listen to it right now. I don't feel like I'm in the right mental state to truly appreciate it. It's like the old rabbinical scholars who would, you know, tie a rope around me before I entered the chamber where the Torah is located in case I die in religious ecstasy, and that way you can pull me out without endangering yourself. Like, I'm kind of the same way when it comes to listening to Kenny Loggins. Like, I have to do it in small doses or I could be overcome by the sheer beauty of Kenny Loggins' music. Water Torture, our car. I guess that's a band name. Watch this. Now this song that I was like, yeah, let's listen to this instead of Kenny Loggins, that'll blow up my car. It'll be a copyright strike, man. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't mind a Latin station. I guess this is the world music station. Oh, Wolfman Jack, theme song, baby.
Get bombs, Oli. Good boy.
There you go. Now, part of me is curious about visiting this other location. But I'm not sure what the point would be. Like, I'll either find a vehicle there that would have worked for this quest, or I won't. I'm not gonna bother to go check it out. It could just be a curiosity about how the way this guy constructed his video. I'm just gonna get back to Michael DeSanta headquarters and throw down a save here. Again, it's a good neighborhood to be in if you're just looking to steal cars, because doesn't seem like this one, we did have to break the window, but I mean, all the cars up here are awesome. It's a game set in LA where there are sections of the city that are supposed to be where, like, ultra wealthy people live, but they don't have a lot of security stuff. Hey, brother, Chris and his senior thesis, our elders are happy. Chris Fromage, that is the leader of this cult, by the way. Dominator. Everything I do, I dominate. You're progressing well, brother. Chris and the senior thesis holders are very happy with the vehicles you sourced to further craft's work. You are firmly on the path to enlightenment and divinity, but it is a long and expensive path, and there are many more trials ahead. Are you ready to understand the technology of your existence? Are you everything you need and less than more and more? Until next time, brother. Craft be praised.
Hello?
Kraf? Zoloff? Wait, I'm Zoloff. Am I Zoloff? What's that? There's like a cute thing going here with this guy is bending over and his... You didn't get the memo. Oh, never mind. Like, am I crazy or is it supposed to look like... It's a guy crying in his hands. Is it supposed to also look like something else? Is there some humor going on there? You tell me. Because I thought it was like a dude bent over with his ass sticking out of the big long red dong. But there might be some other double visual entendre pun that I'm not seeing. So I kind of wish I knew what the next Epsilon mission was so I would know whether there's a point in... There we go. Let's just go get what it is. And then I'll have to figure out, is this a thing to be done on screen or off screen? Because one of them, like, the trick is... it's just a thing where a ton of game time has to pass. And I think the best technique is just to sleep for days. But there's another one where I think you have to... it's this freaking... It's always this freaking farm up here. Oh, hold on, let me see something real quick. Did I keep any kind of page on the apps? No, I think I closed them all. Damn it. All right. All right, we'll call it a video, and when we come back next time, we're going to drive up there. Because I thought, you know, if it turns out, if I get all the way up there and it is something we should have done off screen, well, I guess maybe we'll be doing it on screen together. See you in a mo. And, well, I mean, I'll be recording again in a moment. No, you can keep right on going, actually. I will be uploading this in a batch of three. So there is really very... If you watch this the minute it comes out, you might have like a 2-minute wait. Otherwise, the next video is available. Watch it when you want, folks. You don't have to watch it at all. You are a free being, Kiflom.